Well, this is gonna be a sloppy, muddy experience, and hopefully I don't end up on my butt. All the snow melted. We had a ton of snow. It all melted. And then last night it was like above zero, like I think it was between 10 and 14 degrees. I don't know, I don't follow the weather. I just know if it's freezing or it's not. And then last night it dropped below zero and we got a little bit of snow, but make no mistake, it is sloppy mess down here. I've been down here a while and I'm working on a little scouting mission here for a secret crazy bipolar manic idea that I had months ago. I kid you not, and I know now it's a little crazy, but I thought, hey, why not? I'm gonna do it. So I'm out here in the woods that I would normally walk. I swear I'm gonna end up on my ass. I really am. So I'm out here scouting for a couple of locations for this experiment of mine, you know, and I've been procrastinating. I'm like, oh, it's too windy, it's too cold, it's too much snow, it's raining. Oh, I just can't bother, I'm too busy. Always excuses and more excuses. That's what I do. Dang it. This whole thing's all icy, sloppy goodness. The river is up super, super high, which was making me a little bit nervous. I almost used this as an excuse not to do this. I'm like, oh, the river's gonna be too high. You know, but it looks like it's not up here. I don't know if you can see it back there. We're definitely gonna go take a look. I think this river's the highest I've ever seen it in all the years that I've lived in London. Well, I was thinking of doing one spot up here because this, I'm not sure if you can even get a sense of it. So the river's there. I'm not sure if you guys remember any of the other videos. That river is extremely high. You can see it moving very, very quickly. I'm gonna actually go down there because I wanna see just how far up this goes. Because honestly, if this is the highest I've seen it, then it's a good information. It's good information for me to know where I can do this experiment. But I was thinking of doing it up here, which is like a higher kind of plateau area. So maybe I'll do something here, something down there. This area down here tends to get more saturated. There's more water, there's more sort of marshy type plants and stuff down there. So it is a very different sort of environment for this little project that I'm about to embark on this year. Wow, that river is just a motoring along. It's actually going quite fast. I mean, if you're around rivers, you would know. And this is a huge amount of water that's flowing through here. I couldn't tell you how many feet across, but I don't know. What do you think? Maybe 150 feet across, maybe 200 feet, maybe more. I don't know. Obviously, I'm not really good. I shouldn't be a map maker. All I know is that this line here would normally be out further there and it wouldn't be near close to that side there. Further on down here, I guarantee you that the entire path is washed out because this has kind of gotten a little bit of an embankment. But further down, I'm not even sure if I'm gonna go down that far because I've seen it washed out before and the river wasn't even close to this high. So when you can see some of the trees are under the water and everything like that. This is what I meant by those, like the low level stagnant marsh type things. I mean, it's winter time and you can already see that there's a pool built up here. And for most of the summer, if not through the entire summer, this will actually stay like a little marsh. It holds the water. I think just because it's so close to the water table of the river, they tend to stay saturated. So finding a spot down here will be very difficult. This is by far my favorite part of this path. I know if you've been with me for a while, you know I say that all the time. And I normally sing My Girl, you know, in the pines by Nirvana. Well, it's not Nirvana, but they did a remake of it. It always reminds me of that. The reason why I love this area so much is that you got the Carolinian forest back there, you know, a lot of the deciduous trees, and then all of a sudden you get all these pines here, and it just reminds me of up north, Northern Ontario, especially Algonquin Park, one of my favorite places to go. Wow, that river is so crazy high up. Oh my God. Look, you can see where the tree line is right there. That's the tree line, and it's well over. Wow, it's so crazy high. I know. Yes, we get it. We get it, Niels. There's a lot of water. It's spring. It happens. Shut up. I like it. Simple things amuse simple minds, people. Oh, now we're going up. Down at the bottom there, where, you know, I was like, oh, well, I'm gonna try and do sort of a lower plateau experiment and one up at the higher area where it's not gonna be super saturated with water and everything. My concern down here is that it's right close to the main path. So, you know, when you mix in humans with what I'm trying to do, it can get destroyed, but it might be a good factor. It might be a relevant factor to see what happens. Do people embrace it? Do they destroy it? Do they vandalize it? Or are they fascinated by it? You know, which is what I'm going for. I'm going for the fascination, the, oh my God, that looks awesome kind of experience for people. And, but the problem is this year I need to see how nature takes hold of this experiment. That's a critical, important part, because some of these places that I'm thinking of going to are way out of urban areas. So it's not gonna be a lot of people that generally enjoy, you know, the wilderness and know better than to disturb it, chop trees down, that sort of stuff there. But it might be a good social aspect of it to see the human element and what happens to my little project when that happens. But look at that water, man. Crazy. I know, I keep showing it to you. It's springtime. You know what that huge amount of water runoff means? We better get going up. I gotta go up on the upper end here. We're going up onto the upper plateau, and then we're gonna find a spot up there, hopefully. But anyway, all this runoff, as crazy high as that is, you know what that means? Black flies. Now, if you guys don't live in an area where there's a lot of mosquitoes and black flies, let me give you a little rundown quick. Mosquitoes love stagnant water, ponds. You know, when you have your buckets or stuff in your backyard that are filling up with water, empty them or else you'll have a ton of mosquitoes. Now, with black flies, which are like tiny, teeny little, they look like almost like fruit flies. They're very, very small, but they go in crazy clouds and they are voracious and they will attack your face so bad, and they come out heavy in the spring. And what they like is running water. And there's a whole heck of a lot of running water. That's for sure. All the little streams, everything. That just means that this spring, if you guys are in the near north or in the north, or you're thinking about heading up there in the spring, don't. And if you're up there already, I feel bad for you. They are gonna be out in record numbers, I guarantee you. Whew. All right, time to break off the path. Because this is a secondary path, and they're like, this is private property, you're not supposed to be here, but it's all continuous forest. I guess people just don't want them building on it, but you know, sometimes when it's just natural forest and people just want to hike through, I don't know how you feel about it, but it's like, dude, I'm just walking in there, I'm not doing anything, you're not producing anything on it, it's attached to the actual designated hiking trails and stuff like that. I don't know why the companies do that. They're like, don't come here, no trespassing, blah blah blah. But I need to go off the path a little bit. I need to go to places where, and sorry for the wind, by the way. I have a dead cat on this mic, but you know, they only work so well. Anyway, I need a place that's off the beaten path. Not too far, but, oh shoot, this is gonna be muddy. The problem with doing it now is that a lot of this is frozen. So, I don't know, come the spring or after spring, it may be just absolutely decimated with water and swamp and kind of make this trip a waste. But there's nothing like going out. You gotta go out there and do your work. This might actually be a good spot. But here's the thing. I need to find a spot. Oh, you know what? I just remembered. I didn't even tell you what the idea was. The whole time you were probably like, What are you talking about? What are you building? What is your idea? You maniac. Fair enough. You know, I just get in and I'm like, whew, let's go. Let's start filming. Let's get out there. All right, well, tell you what, when I find a spot, I'll explain the idea to you. And yes, it's a little crazy, but I'll explain why I'm doing it. And hopefully it works out, because I'd be super excited if it did. And it would inspire me to go out there and do some crazy things. It's a little crazy. Oh man, I just missed it. I don't know if you guys can see. I just saw 2 to 3 deer running that way. Big, what is it, white-tailed deer? I don't know, man. I'm not a hunter. Pretty sure they're white-tailed deer. They blend in. They're actually right there. There's no way for me to point them out to you. Can you actually even see them moving at all? No? Dang it! You stupid camouflage deer built for survival. Right there, look, whole bunch of them. You see that? You see them going? Dang it, I'm like surrounded by deer. I'm like clueless. They were like right in here. Couldn't even, I'd be like the worst hunter ever. I'm like, I don't know where they are. They're like eating out of my backpack. What a maroon. All right, well, this spot seems like a fairly decent place to explain what it is I'm doing. Oh good, and look at that. Yeah, nice how dark that is. That soil there, super dark, really, really rich in organic, you know, stuff. I don't know what the word is. I can't remember. It's not like I'm gonna research this. I'm also not a gardener, but I do know that nice top quality topsoil is nice and dark like that, just meaning it's got a lot of nutrients, which is perfect for my little project. And what is this project, you ask? If you didn't ask, I'm gonna tell you anyway. Gonna give you a backstory here, and I'll make it as quick as possible, which I'm not usually really good at, and I'm already wasting time saying that I'm not really good at it. But anyway, backstory. Long ago when I was a teenager, yes, I was one of those at one point. Long, long ago in a galaxy far, far away. I lived near a river, and there was a forest nearby as well, where all the bush parties happened. Yeah, that's right, I was close to the party time. Anyway, one summer, I was super bored, like, I don't know why. You know how you get when you're bored. If you're a teenager now and you're like, oh, I'm so bored, you have no idea what boredom is without internet, without your phones, without all this other stuff. That's real boredom. We found boredom. And to counter that, we would go outside and play. Now, I'm not attacking you at all. I'm just saying those are the facts. Like, there really was nothing else other than watching TV or going out and hanging out and mucking about in the forest. And that's what I did. But I wasn't like a young teenager. I was like, I think 18. I think it was around 18 or 19. So fairly old. Fairly old, should know better. Anyway, I got this idea, and likely, I must have been bipolar back then as well, because that idea is just as crazy, because I'm trying to relive it now as well. Anyway, I found a part of the forest. I went out and I got flowers, and I bought all these sort of things, grass seed, flowers, everything like that. And then I found this spot, and it was me and a good friend of mine. I can't remember her name. I feel so bad. We were good friends. Not girlfriends or anything like that, just a really good friend. She was awesome. And she helped me bring all these flowers and grass seeds and all this other stuff into this remote location. Well, not exactly like this, but you can imagine, like something like this. And what we did was we planted this garden. We created this scene with flowers and grass and everything like that. And then we let it take shape. And then a few weeks later, we told our friends, because we were all around and I think we were drinking at the time, we're like, oh, we did this, and like, what, really? So we all got up, we all took them there, and they were like, what the? And it was awesome. There was like, in the middle of this forest, when you don't expect it, you come across this little oasis, this little spot with just color just going bam, because everything else was brown and green, and then you come across orange, yellows, reds, purples, blues, all this sort of stuff, and it was just like color slamming you in your face, and it was awesome. And even though, you know, they were teenagers and it was a weird thing to do, because I don't think teenagers normally do that, even our friends were like, wow, that is awesome looking, what is wrong with you? Which was probably an appropriate response. So my idea years later is to actually try and do something similar to that. For now in my head, the operation is called cultured paradise. You know, like in a pearl, natural pearls are very expensive, but in the pearl industry, you get cultured pearls, which are still grown by the actual, clams or oysters, or I think it's oysters. But they put a catalyst in there, like a seed or a grain of sand, and then the oyster will naturally develop a pearl around it, and that's called cultured pearl. So creating these little pockets of paradise, and what I want to do is to go in places like this, into forests, along paths, the Bruce Trail, Algonquin, in these little areas, and create these pockets of paradise that are out of nowhere, just colors and flowers and everything like that, slamming people in the face, and people not knowing whether or not it's natural or not, because I need it to grow over. And that's why it's important that you never bring, if you've ever seen my Twitter, I was like, no bringing outside materials and stuff like that in. So, because it needs to grow naturally. It needs to grow naturally. It needs to let nature kind of like smooth over the edges, you know, let it take time to not just grow these perennials, which is every year they will come up, if you know, in that area there, but nature will soften it and turn it into its own real paradise, and hopefully people won't be able to tell the difference. All they'll know is that there's a spot where this amazing punch of color and this beauty that normally would not have been there. All right, I gotta find my way out of this forest and find the path again. I think if I just keep walking this way, I should be able to come across it. Ooh, it's really swampy in here. Luckily there's a tiny bit of a crust on there because the temperatures drop below freezing again. Oh my God. For deers, they moved through this like it was nothing. They were just like hopping and running like beasts. Me, I'm like, okay, where do I go now? I just gotta go in the roughly the right direction, and hopefully I get out of here. It's been a long time since I've been outside. You hear me huffing and puffing? I'm like, I've been walking for hours. No, maybe like half an hour. Ooh, deer poo. I wasn't really excited about it. It's just confirmation that this is a spot that they love. Okay, this really sucks. What am I doing in here, man? Oh, we gotta get out. We gotta get out. We gotta get out. Oh, get out of here. Deep in the wilderness where there's no technology. Shut up, plane, you're ruining it. You're ruining the illusion. The illusion of crazy adventures. Deep in the jungles of Canada's urban forests. Shoot, where do I go? This way, maybe? Oh, that's not a plane, that's a train on the other side. I was wondering why. I'm like, damn, that thing sounds close. Impact imminent. You know, this may be bad now walking through this, but I'm just thinking about this. In the summer, all of this is just going to be absolutely covered with leaves and vegetation. Getting back here is going to be a nightmare. It's going to be an absolute nightmare. Oh well, that's part of the adventure. If it was easy, I wouldn't feel any accomplishment, would I? Oh, there's the other houses too. I'm getting close to the backs of them. All right, where's the dang trail, man? Get me out of here. Oh. See, poop, fresh deer poop. I bet you if I touched one of those, it'd be all squishy and chewy like a high chew, my new favorite candy. Hi, high chew, you wanna sponsor me? You can, I love your candy. It's delicious, it's Japanesey goodness. Oh, so good, high chew. Finally found the path, that's a good thing. I forgot, there's also a lot of bushes with thorns. They're shredding my pants. All right, wind, calm down. I know your nature. I am powerful. Try to record in this. Jerk. So, this forest isn't really even that big. Honestly, it's not that big. And yet I have no idea where I am. I thought I did back there because I was like, oh, there's the houses, and then that will be this. And then it was like, okay, wait, why are the houses there? And now I'm on a path in an area that I have no idea. I think the river, I think that's gotta be the river there. I see a ton of sunlight, which, you know, a lot of this is blocked, but the river, it's open, so naturally you're gonna get more sunlight. That's me using my brainy parts. I was thinking about it. like, hey, wait a minute. Oh, is this a river crossing here? Where the heck am I? And why does it sound like I'm gonna fall through some ice? Like, this is a major, major path, obviously. And the stream, maybe I've been on the stream further down, but I don't ever recall coming across this stream here, nor this path. Like, I just, hey, you! Oh, I thought it was gonna be thorns again. Thorns. Ooh! Slippery. Oh, that's heaven. That sound is heaven to the black flies. They're like, oh, do you hear that? Let's breed and feast on the humans. In terms of the idea that I have, this, let's just call it Operation Cultured Paradise. It sounds weird. You got a better name suggestion for it? Go ahead. Let me know in the comments. I'm always looking for something, you know, I think, oh, that's a good name, and then it's like, that sucks. That name was just lazy. It was just lazy. But anyway, this idea I've actually had for a number of months, but I have undiagnosed bipolar, which means I have manic episodes, and then I have really lows. But I'm medicated now, and I've only been medicated for bipolar, I don't know, maybe a year, which does explain a lot of times when I get all these impulsive ideas and I go out and I start filming and then it ends and you're like, what the heck? You start, you stop, you start, you stop. Those are cycles. As much as I have to fight through them, and hopefully with my medication and everything, this kick at the can will be a little bit better. No promises, but I'm excited to do it. And, coming out here and doing Cultured Paradise, I do believe was during a manic episode. I'm like, that's the greatest idea I've ever had. I'll do it. People will love it. They'll be like, look at this. Look what I found. Who is this crazy person creating paradise for the public? Or it'll just be some silly project. Like, why are people wasting time planting flowers in the forest? I don't know. I'm not really worried about it. It makes me happy. It makes me happy thinking about it, so that's why I'm doing it. But I have to wait weeks. I have to wait months now on ideas because I know how I am. I know that I start things and stop things. So when I have an idea, I have to be like, ah, probably during one of your crazy little manic episodes where you think everything is good. And the problem with that is that during that time when I'm doing it, I have so much energy and I can keep it up. But when I go down on the lull, when I go down on the depression side, it's very hard, if not impossible, for me to keep up. Do you understand? Does that make sense? I shouldn't say, do you understand? Do you want me to write it down? Draw some pictures for you? You know what I mean? So because the idea required so much energy to maintain, when I go down into a lull, which will happen because it's all cycles, I can't maintain it. And then I stop doing it. I stop doing it. So I have to have something. When I get an idea, I have to wait weeks. I have to wait months even, and make sure that when I'm on a lull moment, that I'm like, you know what? I still like that idea. Even though I'm feeling crap and I don't want to do anything, and I don't want to go out, I still like the idea, which means I may actually be able to pull it off and sustain it long term. So I have to be a little bit smarter with my ideas. Oh, okay, I think I know where we are. Well, I see the river anyway, so it's irrelevant. I just keep walking that way. We'll be good. So this idea I've had for months, but I had to wait for my down moments, which, you know, there's always down moments. We all get down. But mine are like stupid reasons and I can't control. It's just the way my brain works, I guess. But I still like the idea. So I'm like, okay, maybe this will work. Maybe we got a shot at this. So let's do it. Look at that. That in itself stands out, right? And it's dead, right? Obviously you can see it's dying. It's likely not gonna have any more leaves. Well, the bark's falling off there, so you know it's dying. But like for me, artistically, I look at this and I think, okay, if there was enough soil around the base there, It would almost be like a piece of art if you could do like a circumference, almost like a perfect crop circle around it, although it defeats the whole nature did it. But they wouldn't know. Maybe it's the base of the roots and everything like that. And maybe they're like, you know what? The tree is dying and it must be feeding these flowers. But imagine a full blanket, a full thick blanket of just crazy colored flowers in there, just surrounding that, and people coming across seeing that, you know, one without knowing what's going on. And you wouldn't think some crazy person like me is going out here planting flowers, because it is a little loony, I get that. But you imagine that, and then you come up to this and you just see this in green everywhere else, and then just flowers clustered around that. That would look awesome. See, that's the kind of art I think I'd like to create. Nature's art.
Nature.
So this spring and summer, I got two things I want to do. One is experiment with the cultured paradise idea locally, so that I can monitor it throughout the growing season and into the fall. Because if I do anything really far away, the chances of me going back just to check up on some flowers, probably not going to happen. But, and that means that it's going to be longer, like probably 2 years or something like that. Yeah, super long. Anyway, I have to check it, and I gotta see next year how it comes back, because they're perennials. And that brings me to other rules that I have as well, because I love the environment, I love nature, I love the outdoors, and I have the utmost respect for it. And I absolutely cannot stand seeing garbage and waste brought in by people that just have a total disregard for our environment. I'm not pushing environmentalism on you. I just don't like going into the woods or camping or hiking and seeing nature followed by packs of cigarette, you know, empty packs of cigarettes, plastic bottles and all sorts of crap, because people are too damn lazy and have no respect for this planet we live on. It annoys me. That being said, let's get off that, like, oh, I'm all angry at these people. Whatever, I'm here, I'm loving it. So anyway, there's a few rules that I gotta follow. One is don't bring in any outside building materials. I'm not bringing in wood, I'm not bringing in stone or anything, nor would I want to, because I'd have to backpack it in, that would be stupid. But that's not the reason why I don't want to do that. I don't want to bring anything unnatural into the area. Now, in terms of the flowers, you're like, oh, but you're bringing in seeds. All of the seeds and everything that I plan on bringing into these areas, these cultured paradise areas, will be indigenous to the area. There will be wildflower perennial mixes found naturally. The difference is that normally they're scattered all over the place, so you don't really notice them. They're there and they're all over the place in you know, all the seeds and all the flowers that I'm going to be planting. But what I'm doing is concentrating. I'm painting with these seeds, I'm painting with these wildflowers, and putting in sort of clusters of them like nature did in Oopsie or something. But it's important to me that they're indigenous and they're not invasive species. The worst thing you can do is bring in invasive species into any environment if you truly do respect it, you know. So it's very important to me when I'm doing these ideas that I do respect the rules, the laws, and the most importantly, the environment, and have respect for that as well. So nothing that I'm doing, I'm not gonna chop down trees, I'm not gonna do anything. I might move logs or something like that to compose a shot and create this little paradise as I see it in my head, but I will never chop anything down, I'll never do unnecessary damage to the environment. So those are rules for me. And the other thing that I'm gonna be doing this spring, summer, which I'm really looking forward to, because this will all the stuff that I was talking about will be locally, but I'm gonna be taking my boys, and might be all three of them, it might be one of them, it might be two of them, Cal, Ewan, and Liam, and I'm gonna be taking them to camping spots like Algonquin, like I was talking about up north. I'll take them to some of my favorite national and provincial parks and show them these areas that are absolutely beautiful. And the first one that I want to take them to, although it's nicer in the summer, is the Bruce Peninsula in Northern Ontario. If you Google Bruce Peninsula or look up the Grotto or anything like that, look up Five Fathoms National Park and look at the images. Absolutely beautiful, and it actually looks like that. It's so crazy to have this turquoise-like sea. Oh, it's windy. Stop, nature. Stop it. Can't stop it. Anyway, and I'm gonna be vlogging that as well. I'm gonna be bringing them. I want to share those moments because, you know, Liam's getting up there. He's gonna be off soon in another couple of years. He'll be leaving the nest. So I want to capture those moments and share them with you guys, but mainly capture them for myself and for Pam as well. And while we're up there, while I'm experimenting locally, I'm gonna go and scout potential areas up there. I'm not gonna do anything, I'm not gonna plant anything, but if it's successful here, then the following year, I can go up there and do cultured paradise for people that are hiking along the Bruce or whatever and come across these crazy little areas and like, what the heck is going on? I want that sense of awe, that sense of wow, that looks awesome, you know? But I'm gonna be very careful about it so I don't annoy people. Although, let's face it, someone's always annoyed, someone's always angry with what you do, you know? And as long as you're not being ignorant to the main cause that you're doing, which is the environment for me, then whatever. You don't like it, okay, thanks for letting me know you didn't like it, I'm gonna move on. Anyway, that's it. It's been a long time since I've vlogged. I had a lot of fun, showed me how out of shape I am. I gained 20 pounds over the Christmas or the winter sort of season here. Not super good. I blame you, Haichu, you're so delicious, but you'd go straight onto my belly. Anyway, that's it. I'll see you guys in the next weekly video, hopefully. I'm trying to stay motivated. I'm trying to, you know, keep up with Meaty. Meaty's motivating me. If you don't know Meaty or Chris, under his vlog channel, Chris X, from You Always Win. I'm sure most of you know of him. But, you know, he's trying to get out there too. So I'm trying to stay motivated by seeing what he's doing and trying to get out myself. And I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I know, I'm a little crazy. But, c'est la vie. I just roll with the punches, baby.